Greetings everyone, welcome back to my channel Data Sculptor. Today we are going to see another interesting question in SQL. So you have a table called sales and you have two columns, region and amount, and for every region there is an amount. So the question is, you need to find the 90th percentile of each region. So I hope you all understand what a 90th percentile means. So basically percentile is different from percentage. So example, if in an exam, if you score say 80 out of 100, your percentage is 80%, and it is easy to know if you have passed or failed. But so what happens in recent times, they are not people are not announcing your scores in an exam, but instead giving you percentile. Percentile means whether you have crossed the 90th percentile or in the top 10 percentile, or say you are in the top. If you are calculating 90th percentile means, say if your score is above 90th percentile, you are in the top 10%. So in that way. So here 90th percentile means the threshold of the revenue for each region. So in this example for north, you have three values: 1000, 800, and 1200. So between 800 and 1200, which is the minimum and maximum, what is the 90th percentile? So this is the question which we have to solve in SQL. So now let's see how to solve this. So I already have created this table sales, and you can see the DML script in the description of this video. So this is the formula to calculate the 90th percentile. So we have to use the linear interpolation. So here number of rows is n. So take for example for say west region, number of rows is n, desired percentile we have to calculate the 90th percentile, so which is 0.9, and what we have to do is position in the ordered set k, which is n minus 1 into p plus 1. That means 4, n is 4, that is the number of rows for that particular region. 4 minus 1 is 3, 3 into 0.9 plus 1, 3 into 0.9 is 2.7 plus 1, 3.7. and the position, so this is the position in the data where the 90th percentile is present. So the position k, 3.7 is nothing but the k falls between the third and the fourth row, right? That means between 1150 and 1300. So I'm talking about east. So for 1150 and 1300, which is between the third and the fourth values. So now the way you calculate is 1150 plus 3.7 minus mod of k means the nearest integer, I mean the previous integer, closest integer. So the previous integer for 3.7 is 3 into 1300 minus 1500, okay, into the current row minus previous row. So 1150 plus 0.7 into 1300 minus 1150, which is 1255. So for this particular east data, that is ranging from 900 to 1300, so the 90 percentile value is 1255. So this is the formula. So now we have to see how to solve this using SQL. So I hope you all understand how 90th percentile calculation is being done, right? So in order to get these values, so what I have to do, first I'll create select from sales. Here I'll keep region, comma revenue. So it's revenue or amount. Yeah, it is revenue. Revenue, comma. So first we have to calculate the number of rows. Number of rows is nothing but count of 1 over partition by region. So count of 1 over partition by region gives you the total row count for every region. Okay, so I'll keep this as cnt, and what I'll do, I'll create row number over partition by region order by revenue as rn. So with these two values, I'm getting the count for each of every region and row number for that particular revenue in that region. And what I'll do, I need one more value. So here I want previous row as well. So to get the previous, I'll use the lag function, lag of revenue over same, partition by region or by revenue as previous row. So when I run this, you get the previous row. So now you got the previous row, and so what I'll do, I'll keep this in a CTE with CTE as I'll keep this initial details. So init details, something like this I'll keep, and I kept this in CTE. So now next, select star from init details. So this is the calculation init details. So now next, what we have to do, we have to see the position in the ordered set. So we have to apply this formula, which is n minus 1 into p plus 1. So what I'll do, I'll create a new column, select star comma n minus 1. So n is nothing but the cnt count. So count minus 1 into p. Here p means 0.9, right? Because we are checking that 90th percentile, 0.9 plus 1, as we'll keep this as p90. And now if I calculate this, so what we are getting, for each and every row, we are getting the p90th value. So in this 1, 2, 3, 4 rows, the 3.7 row number, I mean the 3.7th value is the p90. So what will I do here? We have to, so as per the formula, right, here we have calculated 3.7, right? So here 3.7, that means the formula here is previous row plus k minus mod k, right? So previous row is the 1500, 1500 plus 3.7 minus 3 into 1600 minus 1500. So what we have to do is, here we have to filter these rows. So in this case, we have to filter the rows where this Rn is greater than p90, okay? So where Rn is greater than p90 is this, where Rn is greater than p90. So if we are doing like this, we will get filtered out with the only the required rows, okay? So in this, we have to apply this formula, previous row plus k minus mod k into current row minus previous row. Here previous row is this particular revenue and current row is this revenue, and we know what is k and what is k is nothing but this 3.7, which is nothing but this p90 minus mod of p90. So that's how we have to hold. Suppose if instead of say 90th percentile, if I want to say 50th percentile, suppose say if I say 50th percentile, here more than one row we will get, right? So suppose if it is 50th percentile, example, we are dealing with a generic solution. So suppose if I want to calculate the 50th percentile, we are getting more than one row for every region. So what I will do, we have to take the least row, okay? So let's add that filter as well to consider the least row, okay? So here I'll let's take 0.9 only, and here also 0.9, and what we'll do, we'll create row number, one more row number over partition by region, order by rank, Rn will do, order by this Rn as Rnn, I'll do Rnn. And now if I do this, we are getting this Rnn 1, right? So after this, we are getting, so I'll keep this in one more CTE, I'll keep this as CTE as, okay? And CTES. So select star from CTE. So if I do the select star from CTE, I'm getting this value, but I'll filter out where RNN is equal to 1. Okay. When I do RNN is equal to 1, it will show the same data because we are doing the 90th percentile, right? So now what I'll do, we have to apply this formula. So region comma, so the formula here is previous underscore row plus k minus mod k. So k is nothing but the p90 minus mod means nothing but here the floor floor function, floor of P 90 into current row minus previous row. So, into current row means revenue minus previous row, as percentile underscore 90. So, if we do, let us see what we are getting. So, yeah, this is the percentiles we have shown earlier in the output. So, this is the 90th percentile value. Okay. So, now instead of doing all this in this, this is a proper formula, this is a mathematical formula to calculate the 90th percentile. So, instead of doing all this, what happens in SQL, we have an inbuilt function called percentile underscore count or count. So, this what we will do, select region comma, this is the formula percentile underscore count of we want to find the 90th percentile, right. So, 0.9 and within the syntax is within group of revenue over partition by region as percentile underscore 90 from sales. So, if I do this, we will directly get the 90th percentile value. So, here multiple rows are coming, so I will keep distinct here. So, now let us compare the data. So, yeah, 1255, 1160, 1940 and 1570. So, this is the inbuilt function in SQL to calculate the 90th percentile. Okay. So, now let us see whether this particular solution without percentile count is working for any other percentile. Say now let us see 50th percentile, which is nothing but the median. Okay. So, instead of 0.9, I will use 0.5 and instead of 0.9, I will use 0.5 and column names let it be the same and here also I will use 0.5 and now if I run this, yeah, if you see even if you use the 50th percentile, the values are the same, right. So, this is the generic solution you have to use to calculate the percentile value and this is the straightforward function to use the percentile value for each group. So, hope you all like this question. So, this is particularly mainly used for analytics where if you want to apply some machine learning algorithms over a set of data. So, in machine learning algorithms, you need to understand statistics, how to apply statistics and all. So, these particular functions and all will be helpful over there. Okay. So, hope you all like this question and also the explanation. If you like this content, please click on the like button and if you click on the subscribe button, you will get more videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.